Hello, this is Jose Luis here, and welcome to the last video in the series Advanced Development in Grasshopper. Oh, we're done. Okay, well, this is good news because I believe that if you have completed and watched through and struggled through all the videos in this playlist or in this course, however you want to take that, then I actually believe that you are in a very good place now and you have all the fundamental knowledge that I believe you should need in order to build your own Grasshopper plugins. So as far as I am concerned, there's going to be, this is what you need. If after this video in this playlist there's any other videos trailing after this, it's because in the future, someone has requested like a particular feature or how to learn something that relates to Grasshopper development. So I may add small chapters or small episodes after this one. But at this point, I think you know everything that you need in order to build your own Grasshopper native plugin. So I have a very strong recommendation for you, which is learning happens very often by doing. So you may have learned a lot from these videos. You may believe that you got it under control, but definitely, I recommend that if you want that knowledge to solidify and stick to your brain forever and ever, give it a try at building your own Grasshopper plugin. There are many ways you can approach that. There are many topics that you can use. So for example, a very common way of building your own plugin is to just build a collection of components with operations that you happen to use very often. So for example, I happen to need to retrieve the last element of a list very, very often, and it's kind of painful to have to drop the list, item, figure out the last number, whatever. So one component that just gives me the last element of the list should be a really useful one. So you can probably develop like your own personal toolbox of components, if you will, and turn it into your component, your plugin, whatever. That would be super useful. Similarly, you may have ideas around a particular topic that you may want to build some tools around. This is typically the way actual Grasshopper plugins are developed out there in the world. You have Grasshopper components for meshes, for elastic deformations, for then physics simulation, for subdivision. Subdivision in itself is already a huge topic. So you may have an idea of some kind of geometry topic that you may build a plugin around, some kind of, I don't know, machine communication requests, WebSockets, something like that. You may want to build something around data management, CSV parsing, things like that. I don't know, cartography. Maybe you are like a very geographical person and you work with GIS and you want to set and develop like GIS components for some reason. There's a lot of things and a lot of topics that you might harness as a theme to develop a plugin around. Successful plugins out there in the world are typically the ones that are very focused on a particular topic, right? Mix and matching, conceptually, it's good for you personally, but for the outside world, it's a little confusing sometimes. And actually, you may see after in this playlist how I have an idea for a plugin that I want to build after this playlist around the topic of AI and around the topic of parsing and pinging all these APIs that are popping up that allow us to use machine learning models and request predictions from the internet. So I may actually build right after this playlist a plugin for AI. So if there's more videos after this playlist, building that plugin or pointing you to that plugin, it may have happened sometime in the future, all right? And also something that is very common is maybe you have found on the internet some kind of C# project that someone has published as a DLL. So it's this file that contains a lot of really juicy and interesting C# code. And what you may want to do is you may want to build a wrapper around that plugin, around that DLL, and turn it into Grasshopper components that use this DLL at the core. This is also a very common practice. You have seen examples of how to do that in this playlist. So you may want to open up the functionality of that DLL for people who do not know how to write C# but may want to use that functionality in Grasshopper. This is called wrappers plugins, and they're very, very common as well. So if you've made it all the way to this playlist, I want to thank you. It was a lot. I understand. Hopefully it's going to be helpful for you. It was a lot for us to develop. It took more than a year to finish this full playlist with some hiccups and personal things going on, but whatever. And now I have to say, though, we put the effort in making this happen. Now it's your turn to make something great with everything that you have learned in this playlist. So I look forward to seeing what you do with everything you've learned. Please, if you do something cool, make sure you let us know on our social media. I'm very accessible on social media, direct messages, but very especially our Discord server is probably the best way for you to share anything that you do with us. Okay, so there is a link at the description if you haven't joined our Discord server yet. And there's a channel called Work Sharing where we will very, very gladly see what you have built yourself. Okay, and hopefully we can also help you broadcast and share this with the rest of the world. Thank you very much. It was a pleasure, and I hope to see you in some other videos, some other playlists, some other work that we do in the channel. And as usual, if this was helpful at all and you like the content, tell your friends, tell your studio buddies, share the news with the world. This is cool. You can learn stuff. And maybe like this channel, subscribe to the channel, like this video, and all those things that we do in YouTube Live these days. Thank you very much, and see you in other videos. Bye-bye.